So welcome guys. So in this lecture, we are going to discuss about the abrasive water jet machining systems. So normally in abrasive water jet machining, where the jet will contain both water and abrasives in a proportion of 70:1. And the main important factors or parameters of an abrasive jet is the size of the abrasive, the shape of the abrasive, the material and the structure, and its mechanical behavior of the abrasive and its distribution. So these will be, I mean, these are the important parameters of an abrasive material. And also the basic, the machining of an abrasive water jet machining consists of these elements. One is abrasive delivery system. So delivery system in sense, it has of two types of delivery system, where one is injection and the suspension. We'll discuss later in the next slide. And we have a control system. We have a pump to pressurize the fluid, nozzle which develops high velocity. We have a mixing tube. We have a motion system. Motion system is normally due to it controls the xy position of the tool. That depends upon the profile and the cutting which you have to make on the workpiece. So we have and these are the two types of delivery system. One is injection and suspension jets. So we also call this side feed and central feed system. So we have water which is coming from the reservoir and enters into a pressurized pressure generation, where it goes to a nozzle. So this is actually a mixing chamber, where water comes from out of a nozzle, and the exit of the nozzle we'll add the abrasives in the side hopper. So that goes in, and that comes out another nozzle, and that goes to a high velocity abrasive water jet that cuts the element workpiece. And this is what a suspension type of system, where the water is directly allowed into the main nozzle, and in intermediate to that tubings, some abrasive is added due to suspension, and that slurry will enter into the nozzle, and that creates high velocity, and that cuts the workpiece. So this is an abrasive delivery system, where automatically the abrasives are stored and that is delivered to the machining centers. So this is an abrasive delivery system. And this consists of a high sensitive sensors, and so this is the control system that controls the flow rate of abrasives, and also the slurry which is prepared. So that is controlled by this control system. So also it also controls the feed rate, the size, I mean, the what mass of abrasives and water should be added. So that depends upon the profile of cut, everything. And we have a pump. Normally it's used to intensify the water jet. So this video we have already discussed in water jet machining. And we have nozzles. So normally this nozzle is made a special type of nozzle that will be made up, it will be made up of coating anything, because it should handle abrasive water jets. So abrasives has a tendency to erode the surface of a nozzle, and so we have a nozzle to accelerate the slurry particles. And we have a mixing tube where the water and the abrasives are mixed, and that becomes a slurry. And we have motion system. As I said, it controls the XY table motion control, so that the tool will move from to certain coordinates of the table, depends upon the profile which we need to cut. And it's made up of three categories. One is floor mounted gantry, an integrated table gantry system, or floor mounted cantilever systems. And this is performance factors, WJM performance factors. So perform water, it's both of our water jet machining and abrasive water jet machining. The jet cutting rate, it depends upon the metal removal rate, surface quality and accuracy, and the workpiece type, thickness, the feed rate, and jet nozzle diameter. Standoff distance is the distance between the nozzle exit and the workpiece. And this is jet fluid. So the type, velocity, type of jet, velocity, flow rate, pressure, viscosity. So these are the factors which will be influencing the performance of water jet machining. And the advantages of this water abrasive jet machining is we have cheaper than other process. Of course, water is primary. 70% of the fluid is water, so it's cheaper. So and it can cut any hard material. Okay, and it can thick or thin stuff can be cut, and all sorts of shape with only one tool. So shapes, whatever profile we need, that can be made out of this machining process. No heat is generated. No, and the generation of heat is very less here. We can account that. And smooth finish, we attain a very smooth finish where good surface roughness is attained. Cutting process without gases or oil, since no special lubricants are required for doing this. And very easy to learn, and it's very safe. And the removes the all at once, and the machine stacks of thin parts are all at once, and it can be removed, and the debris control is easy to handle. Thank you.